Assistant Professor at ITICT Department of LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the 9th lecture of Unit 4. Okay, so in previous lecture, we have learned about a class diagram. Okay, so in class diagram, we have learned about elements like class, attributes, operation and relations. Okay, so in previous lecture, we have completed a class, attribute and a operation element. Now, we will continue the previous lecture by a element of a class diagram, that is a relationship. Okay, so a relationship of any class should be like any generalization and specialization, link and association, then aggregation, composition and a multiplicity. Okay, so you can use any of the relationship for defining a relation between two various classes. Okay, so let's discuss each relationship in a brief. So first is a generalization and a specialization. So a generalization is a process of extracting said characteristics from two or more classes and combining them into a generalized superclass. Okay, so in generalization, you are dividing your class into a subclass. Okay, so subclasses are extracted and two or more classes and then combine them into a general superclass. Okay, for an example, account class have a saving account or a current account. Okay, so here saving account and current account are generalized into a account particular. Okay, so said characteristics can be attributes or method. So attributes and method of saving account as well as current account is accessible by a particular account class. Here generalization represent is a relationship. Okay, so saving account is a account and current account is a account. So here is a relationship is maintained. For an example, a car is a vehicle and truck is also a vehicle. So in this case, vehicle is a general thing, whereas a car and a truck are the more specific things. Okay, and a specialization is the reverse process of generalization. Means you are creating a new subclasses from an existing classes. Okay, so you have a vehicle class and you can specialize that vehicle class into a car and a truck. Same for a account. You are dividing account into a saving account or a current account. Okay, for loan section, either a gold loan or a car loan or a home loan. Okay, so generalization is a process in which you are extracting the said characteristics from two or more classes and then combining them. Okay, so you are generalizing all the things into a one thing. And in specialization, you are creating a new subclasses from the existing classes. So we can say that generalization is a bottom-up approach and specialization is a top-down approach. Okay, so here you can see that vehicle class. Okay, we have written that vehicle in a italic format. So italic format means vehicle is a abstract class. Okay, so vehicle is a abstract class followed by a second compartment means its attributes, that is number of wheels. Okay, so how many wheels that particular vehicle have, that is the attribute. Okay, and a followed by a type, that is a integer. We all know that vehicles are countable. Okay, so it will define in an integer format. Then a operation or a function or method that you can perform on a particular vehicle class, that are start, stop, apply brake, then refill, fuel. Okay, so these are some operations that you can perform on a vehicle class. Okay, now you are generalizing. Okay, so you are generalizing vehicle class into a car and truck. Okay, so generalizing means car and truck are both classes that are generalized in a particular vehicle class. So you can see that arrow from car to vehicle, that is generalization. And here specialization is a reverse process. Okay, so if you are reading a particular class in a bottom-up approach, then it will be your generalization. And if you are reading your class from a top-down approach, then that is your specialization. Okay, so that will be a relationship of any particular classes, either generalization or a specialization. Okay, basically both the things are similar. Okay, so if you are dividing one class into subclass, that is you are specializing it. Okay, so you are specializing that particular vehicle, you are detailing about it. Okay, but if you are combining multiple class into a single class, okay, like summarization, okay, so that is generalization. You have generalized everything, okay, into a particular one class. So this is the concept of generalization and a specialization. Now next is link and association. An association is a description of a group of link with common semantic. And one more thing, it is an optional thing. Okay, so here an association between two classes indicates that object at one end of an association recognizes object at the other end of any may send message to them. Okay, so object at one end to the object of other end. Okay, and they can send a message. Now a link. A link is a physical or conceptual connection among object. Okay, so if we have a multiple object and connection between those objects are defined by using a link. Okay, so link is a physical or a conceptual connection among the objects. Even link and association are the means for establishing relationship among objects and classes. So how one class is related to other class, or how one object is related to other object, that will mention by using a link and association relationship. Okay, here aggregation and composition are the two forms of association. Okay, so association is divided into aggregation and composition relationship, and it is a subset of association. Okay, here means they are specific case of association in both aggregation and composition. Object of one class owns object of another class, but there is a minor difference. Okay, so here you can see that there is a patient's object and a medical history. So patient provide a medical history. Okay, so here link is defined between patient object and medical history object. Okay, so patient and medical history are associated with each other. Okay, so let's discuss about aggregation and composition relationship. As we have already discussed, aggregation is a subset of association. Okay, so it is a subset of association and it is a collection of different things. Okay, a specialized form of association in which a whole is related to its part. Okay, so it represents by a part of relationship. Okay, so here car is a part of vehicle. Okay, similarly aggregation implies a relationship where the child is independent of its parent. Okay, so here child and parent relationship, but here child is an independent attribute. Okay, and it is denoted by placing a diamond. Okay, so you have to define a diamond symbol nearest to the class representing the aggregation. Okay, so here in example you can see that patient that provides medical history. Okay, so patient is a representator, okay, for aggregation. So here you can see a diamond symbol is drawn near a patient object. Okay, so this is a aggregation. Okay, so patient a part of relationship. So medical history is a part of a patient. Okay, so patient have some medical history. So this is defined by a aggregation relationship. Then composition. So it is a strong form of aggregation. Okay, so it expresses the stronger coupling between the classes. So in example, you can see that a person have a hand, heart and a brain. Okay, so it represents a part of relationship. In previous, we can already discuss that aggregation means a part of relationship. Similarly, composition is also a part of relationship. So hand is a part of person. Okay, similarly, heart and brain is also a part of a human body. Okay, so the owner is explicitly responsible for creation and deletion of a part. Okay, so if I am a owner of that particular class, then I can easily add any attribute or remove any of the part. Okay, so I can create or I can delete any of the part of that particular class. Okay, so in composition, both the entities are dependent on each other. Okay, so for an example, person class with hand class, heart class and a brain class. Okay, so if the person class is destroyed, the hands, heart and brain class will automatically discard. Okay, so here person are independent class and the hand, heart and brain is a dependent class. Okay, so hand, heart and brain class is depend on a person class. So if the person class is destroyed, then subclasses of hand, heart and brain will also get discarded. Okay, so it is a strong form of aggregation. Okay, so here same diamond symbol near to the class that you are defining as a main class. Okay, so here person is a main class and followed by a hand, heart and a brain class. Okay, then next is a multiplicity. So here documents how many instances of a class can be associated with one instance of another class. Okay, so multiplicity define a documents. Okay, in which you are defining that how class can be associated with one instance of another class, and it is denote the minimum number. Okay, and a maximum number of instance. Okay, so if there is a relationship like I am a teacher, you are a student. So I am a single person and I am teaching many of the students. So here one to many relationship. Okay, if in your point of view, you are multiple student and I am a single teacher. Okay, so many to one relationship. Okay, so this is known as a multiplicity. So exactly one. If there is a one person and one teacher, then it is exactly a one relationship. Then zero or more. Okay, so like if I am a teacher and I have a either zero student or a multiple student. So for zero, zero dot dot and a star. Okay, or zero to m. M means a number of student. Okay, then one or more. Similarly, zero or more, one or more. So one followed by a star symbol or 1 to the number of n's. Okay, so how many number of students? Then 0 or 1. So either 0 or 1. Okay, so if there is no relationship, means 0. And if 1 to 1 relationship, then you can mention a 1. Then specified range. Okay, so you can also specify a range like 2 to 4, like 6 to 8. So how much relate one class to other class, you can define. And a multiplier disjoint ranges like 1, 3, 5. Okay, so here in example, a patient 1 to many or 1 to 0. So patient have a medical history, so 1 to 1. One patient have a 1 medical history. Okay, or one patient have a 0 medical history. Okay, so patient provide a medical history. So it is a multiplicity. Exactly one means one patient, one medical history. Zero or more means patients have a no medical history. Then one or more, teacher have a multiple student. Then zero or one, either zero or one. Okay, specified range, I have a particular 10 student or 12 student or a 15 student. Okay, so this is all about a multiplicity. Now example, so many to zero or one association. Okay, so here first example is account holder and a checkbook. Okay, so here one to one relationship. one account holder has one checkbook. Okay, as we all know that we have a one account and particular account have a particular checkbook. Okay, if we have a multiple account, then multiple checkbooks are there. But for particular one account, we always have a one particular checkbook, passbook. Okay, so account holder to checkbook. Okay, so account holder has a checkbook. Okay, so account holder one, checkbook one. So 1 to 1. Now many to zero or one association. Account holder issue debit card. So an account holder can issue at most one debit card. Okay, so initially account holder can issue one debit card, and if it expires, then he or she will apply for the another. So many to zero or one association. Okay, next is many to many association. That means account holder withdraw from ATM. Okay, so every account holder can withdraw money from all ATMs. Okay, if I have a SBI bank account, then I can withdraw my money from any of the bank like SBI, BOB, HDFC, from any ATM. Okay, so here many to many association, account holder withdraw from any ATM machine, and a bank have branch. So bank should have at least one branch. Okay, so if any bank is there, then it should always a specific branch name. Okay, so in Ahmedabad city particular, we have a multiple SBI bank, but all SBI have particular branch. Okay, and particular IFSC code. Okay, so one to one or many association, that means bank have a branch. Okay, so you can define multiplicity by using this symbol. Okay, now let's move to the actual class diagram of any food ordering system. Okay, here you can see that I have mentioned all the relationship, like there are multiple classes. Okay, so first class is a customer class, followed by a order class, followed by the order detail, then particular item. Okay, and order is payable. Okay, so payment class, and payment class is divided into cash, check or any credit. So let's start with a customer class. So customer class, here class name is a customer, attributes are like name of that customer and the address of that particular customer. Okay, now multiplicity. So 0 to 1 or 1 to many. Okay, any customer can order any amount of item. Okay, so here one to many relationship, and association line between two classes, customer class and a order class. So that is association. Then a order class. So order class have a attributes and operation. Okay, so here, so order have a attributes like date and status. So on which date particular customer have ordered that food, and the status, either it is a pending or successfully delivered to the customer. So these are the attribute for particular order class. And operation like subtotal, total. Okay, so these are some operation performed by a particular order class. Okay, now order details. Okay, so now what item a customer is ordering, that will mention in a order detail. Okay, how many number of item are ordered by a customer, that will also mention. So here aggregation, a diamond symbol at order. Okay, so at order class, here you have defined a diamond symbol. So here a diamond symbol define a aggregation. So order and order detail are aggregated with each other. Okay, then next is a payment class. Here one order, one particular payment. Okay, so here payment is defined. You can see that payment is defined as a abstract class. Okay, why? It is written in a italic format, and a person can payment by cash payment or credit or any online transfer. Okay, so here you are generalizing payment into cash, check and a credit. So this is the diagram of food ordering system. You have mentioned in different 8 classes: customer, order, order detail, then item, then payment. Payment are generalized into cash, check and a credit. Okay, now let's discuss another example. So class diagram of bank management system. Here class is bank, ATM, branch, account. Account have either a current account or a saving account and a customer. Okay, so here you can see that multiplicity is also defined, generalization is defined. Okay, so bank is a class name. It have a attribute like name of that bank and a particular code like IFSC code, bank branch name. Okay, and followed by a particular operation that is manage a particular branch. Then a branch. Okay, so another is a branch class. Branch class have a branch name, branch code. Okay, and it have operations like branch class can manage any account and perform any transaction of customer. Okay, now next is a ATM class. Okay, so ATM class have attribute like location. What is the location of attribute? Okay, and by whom it is managed. Okay, so location and managed by, these are two attributes of ATM class, and it have one method like transaction. Okay, so you are performing any transaction. Then next is a customer class. So customer have attributes like name of that customer, address of that customer, phone number, date of birth, PAN card. Okay, so these are the various attributes. And customer have operations like manage account. Okay, he or she can manage its own account. Okay, and he or she is able to perform any transaction. So transaction is another method for particular customer class. And similarly, account class. Account class have account number and account information. And operations like debit account, then credit account. Okay, and any transaction details. Okay, and it is generalized into a current account and a saving account. So this is the whole class diagram of any bank management system. And here you can see that multiplicity, aggregation, generalization, all the relationships are mentioned between two different classes. Okay. Now next is a class diagram for library management system. So here you can see that librarian, member, material, these are the main classes. Librarian have a name, particular contact number, and he or she is performing addition of book, any updation of book. So various operations are performed by a librarian. Okay, so librarian is manage any member. Okay, so member class have attributes like name, contact number of that particular member, type of that member. Okay, so either it is a visiting member or a regular customer. Okay, then other operations like add member, update member, issue any book, return any book. So these are some operations that will perform by a particular member class. Then material. If library have some material, then it have an attribute like material name, in category name, in which category that particular material is exist, like it is a magazine or a study material or any comic book. Okay, and it also have a various operations like add that particular material, update any material, you can remove it, you can delete that particular material or return a material. Okay, then material is divided into book, question paper, CD or DVD or any magazine. Okay, so you are specializing a material class into a book class, question paper and a CD DVD class. Okay, so you can see that material is a abstract class written in a italic format. Okay, similarly member is generalized into a staff or a student, either it is a staff member or it is a student. Okay, for college, if you are staff, then you can issue a multiple number of books, but if you are a student, then you have a limited number of book you can issue. Okay, so all the classes have different categories and a particular operation. Okay, so this is all about a class diagram of library management system. Okay, and here also a multiplicity is defined like one to many, many to one, one to one. Okay, and generalization, specialization and aggregation. Okay, so that's all for the today's lecture. We have studied in today's lecture is about a class diagram, relationship and a example of class diagram. Thank you.